What is going up, guys? Your boy Epic Viper 13. Today, I'm gonna make a quick video of how much I paid for my Hellcat. I'm just gonna be honest with you. So I'm gonna show you how much I pay. And I got my splitter here. I'm gonna be making another video on installing it. But of course, also my brother's car. It's right here, the Miata. It looks cool, look, same color. Kind of the same color, but it's a different like shade. But this is like pretty cool color. And of course the Hellraiser. Here, let me show you a little bit better. So my brother put the splitter there. My dad painted the wheels there, so they're gonna be white. So of course my brother likes JDM, and this is the car. This is his second Miata. He has another one, but that one's broken down. It's gonna get fixed soon. I think it just needs a PCM to get fixed. And of course this is the Hellcat. Hellcat is pretty big, of course. Hello, I'm right there. Hellcat emblem. Guys, like, I don't know. It just feels unreal that I actually have this car. If you guys watched me since the beginning, when I didn't have a car, and you watch, like, how I went from that to here, look, hard work pays off. So this is my Hellcat, of course. And if you don't, if you haven't followed me on my Instagram, here's my Instagram page. HellKittySRT. What's up, guys? And then, of course, Hellkitty SRT. And of course, my brother tried putting these seats on, but I guess the bracket down there doesn't fit. So he has to reorder the bracket and get a new ones. But he's going to install these ones. So it's going to be like kind of like my car, with red interior, the same color, kind of same color shade, just a different paint. Of course, these. And like I was saying, my brother's car got stolen. When we used to live in San Jose, they stole the hardtop. Hardtop is easy, like $1,000, but, you know, stuff happens. But, of course, we still have the car back. He also installed quick release, as you can see. That's pretty cool. Later in the future, I want to get, like, a Miata or a GDM car or a manual car because I want to learn how to drive manual. I don't know how to drive that well. I speak real. I don't know how to drive manual for sure. So, something, if my brother fixes it up, he said he's going to teach me how to drive manual. I guess it's pretty easy, but you just got to get used to stepping on the clutch and changing the gear. Of course, automatic does it for your own. Does it on itself. This takes more skill. So, of course, props to my brother. And I hope I learned. I can probably make a video on that later on. I'm going to get inside the car, and I'm going to talk to you guys. Here we go. Yes, sir. Of course, look, last video I made, we installed that. But let's get right into the video. All right, guys. So this is the sticker on my car. I want to laminate it because, of course, this is something I want to keep forever. You know, it's a really big milestone on achieving this goal. You know, not a lot of people can do it. But if you guys have the mindset of getting this car, anybody can. Your like mind is so super, super strong. If you put any like goals in your mindset, you're able to achieve them. And here, I'm going to show you. I'm going to turn the camera, but of course. So I'm just going to tell you, it's a 2022 Charger SRT Hellcat wide body. I got the 2022 because when I went to get the 2021, they stopped making the 2021s. The only one was 2022. And so, of course, I had to go with the 2022. So I did custom order it. As you can see, I'm going to show you right here. It has my name, my full name, Brian Guerrero. That's my name. And, of course, it was custom made for me. But this car took 4 months, 5 months to get to me. I ordered it in June 18th. I think from there, I went to, like, my cousin's 15s. I forget where I went, but I think we went to Oregon. Yeah, it was my cousin, my little cousin's 15th. Like, I'm a Mexican, so we do a quinceañera. So it's a 15-year-old. And I went to Oregon, like, 2 days after. And from there, I just got it October 2017, so around there. So I think it took about, 4 months to get the car. It was really... I was really anxious to get the car, and of course I got it. And so basically I ordered the Dodge Hellcat SRT wide body, of course, for the Charger version. There's no slim version anymore. So if you want a custom order or any Hellcat, That is a charger. There's no more slim body. You can get still a slim body red eye. You can get a slim body super stock, I think, or I'm not sure, but you, I know you can order a slim body red eye and a regular Hellcat Challenger, still in slim body, but on the charger you can't anymore. So I got the 2022 Charger SRT Hellcat. Base price was $77,345. And I remember that I was gonna buy this car like a month or two before I ordered it, and the car was like $1,000 or $2,000 cheaper. And then when I tried to order it again, it went up in price by like $1,000 or $2,000. So, and then, you know, the price keeps increasing every time. So of course, the base price is $77,345, but of course they added like I added some optional equipment, but of course the wide body is extra, but it already comes included. So I added the Hellraising exterior paint, which was $395. Of course, the white one and black I think come free, but for this paint especially, is $395, which isn't as bad. Custom package, I got the black demonic red seats, which is the red seats right there. Of course, I had to get that. Either I was gonna get this red seats, or I was gonna get the peanut butter seats, because the peanut butter seats, it looks pretty cool because it was gonna look like peanut butter and jelly. But of course, the red seats, I always wanted a car with red seats, which I never did, because my Scat Pack was cloth seats, my RT was cloth, and my Chrysler 300 was cloth. So of course, this is like best one. There's actually Hellcats with cloth, with cloth seats, that like, hell no, I wouldn't even buy that car. Like, I wouldn't buy a Hellcat with cloth seats. And then I, of course, I got the power sunroof over here. That's an extra $2,100. I had to have the sunroof because I like the sunroof. When you put it up, it looks cool. It's like a aesthetic. And then of course the gas guzzler tax. We're in California. I know a lot of other states don't get that tax, but this is the gas guzzler tax, of course, because we're in California. It's a $2,100 charge, and then the destination charge is $1,595. So the total price of this car was $83,825. And of course, I didn't pay this. I got a $1,000 rebate from Dodge, so basically went down to $82,825. And I did give a big down payment. I gave him basically in total with the $1,000 rebate, it was a $16,000 down payment. I did save that, and yeah. So I'm gonna be making more videos on you guys about the payment, but or I can just put in this video. So basically, my payments are basically a grand, for 72 months. And then, you know, I think I'm going to refinance basically in a year or two, because the interest rate is kind of high now because of what's happening, interest rate. So the interest rate was about, I think it was like 5.7 or 6%. So I know on the previous one, my interest rate was 3% on my Scat Pack. So of course, interests have rose, but let me flip it. As you can see, Dodge Charger SRT Hellcat, base price 77. Here is the 8-speed auto, 6.2 supercharge, black demonic red interior, Hellcat Hellraising exterior. And it comes with all these standard equipment now. So airbags, active head, line lock, after chiller, launch assist, anti-spin differential, red brake calipers, SRT drive modes, blind spot detection, which is pretty much comes included, the 8.4 inch touch display, blind spot, like I said, remote start, that's basically every car has that now. And yeah, and then pretty much Google Android Auto, integrated voice command, 6 premium Alpine speakers. Sounds pretty good. That's why I didn't go with the Harman Kardon, because you know, Alpine is pretty good. It sounds amazing. If I wanted to upgrade it, I'll upgrade it aftermarket. And pretty much I kept the 20x11 split 5 black wheels. And of course, that's the extra stuff. So $83,000. I did add extra warranty protection, because this is the car I'm going to keep for a while. Maybe just keep it forever. So I added like 100,000 mile powertrain warranty instead. Pretty much $200 deductible if anything happens. So it's protected by pretty much everything, like engine, anything, cosmetic, stuff like that. And of course, it came from Canada. But hey guys, that's pretty much it. That's pretty much how much I got my car for. And I didn't pay no markups. Pretty much the cars that they had in the lots, like inside, those ones were like $10,000-$15,000 markup, which is insane. I went to order it, and yeah, they said if you ordered, custom ordered, that you wouldn't pay no markups. It was on MSRP. So I went to order one because, of course, I'd rather wait for a Hellcat the way I wanted it to look rather than paying like extra $10,000-$15,000 markup. And that's just like a waste of money. So I got this car MSRP. Now guys, this it's basically December now. I know it's kind of hard to order one. I think they closed the orders for 2022. A lot of you guys that still want to buy a Hellcat, it's kind of hard now, guys. You would have to buy a used one now. If you want to buy a new Hellcat, I don't know if it's even possible now, because the 2023 models are more hard to get. Why? Because every dealership you go to, they have allocations. Allocations means that they have like a certain amount of cars they can order per per dealership. So say the one that I ordered was here in Gurra, California. I live in California. So if you check online, they have about three or four Hellcat allocations. So they're only allowed to order four Hellcats for the 2023 model. So I don't think they're going to be doing MSRP anymore because they only have four to order. So basically the people that pay the highest markup is going to get that allocation. And of course the lights went off. But yeah, so I think it's going to be really hard for the 2023 model since it's the last model. Dealerships are just going to be doing markups on those allocations. So I'm blessed that I actually got the 2022 model, that I had the chance to afford one and buy one, because I know if I didn't buy it now, you know, I would have never been able to buy it later, because of course I wasn't going to pay no markup, first of all, and it's just really limited. Maybe it's already sold out. So I'm blessed that I bought the 2023 models look the same. The only thing the 2023 would have is just a sticker that is just the last call. So, you know, it's the last Charger ever made. The 2021 and the 2022, the only difference is the headlights. The headlights. So I got the 2022 model. So the directional like light is pretty cool. Instead of the middle, I can show you after. I'll show you right now. So yeah, guys. So let me show you that. And this is, I want to put this, like engrave it and just pretty much have it in my wall, because this is a great accomplishment. So let me show you the lights that I'm talking about. This is the what I'm talking about. You see how this whole thing lights up? So that's different before. Only this part used to light up orange. So this part right here only turned. Now the whole light does that. So that's how you can tell that I got the 22 model instead of the older models, just by that light. So if you see Hellcats or Scapex with that type of light, that means it's a newer one. So that's how you can tell you have a 2022 model, a 2023 instead of the 2021 and under. Because I have the Scapex. My Scapex was 2019. And it did the middle used to light instead of the whole thing. So yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Just a quick video. If you guys want to get a Hellcat, a Scapec, you know, I think it's gonna be hard. I know you can get a Scapec easier because they're easier to get. Hellcats, I don't know, they just made it so hard to get now. You can still get a Hellcat or Scapec used. You can easily find them. But for used, I would rather wait maybe next year, that the market is, you know, slows down and stuff like that, just because right now they're pretty expensive. I wouldn't buy a used car right now. Maybe next year, because used cars are going to drop in value, you know, with the car stuff happening. So, yeah. So, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, smack the like button. I'm going to be doing more Hellcat videos. I'm going to install the splitter. I bought a lot of stuff. I'm going to be installing my Revelco system. Of course, Hellcats and Scatpacks get stolen a lot. Here in California, where I live, don't really get stolen a lot. I don't want to jinx that. But of course, it does happen, mostly in the city. So I'm just going to be more cautious. I don't really take my Hellcat everywhere. There's certain places where I wouldn't take it. And of course, I'm going to be installing my Revoco system, which is like a kill switch. I install a lot of stuff, like the other video I did where I installed my like neutral strap blocker, stuff like that. But hey guys, hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm going to be doing more videos, and how much, I already told you how much I pay for my Hellcat. How can I afford it? I'm going to be telling you how to apply for those jobs. You know, you can make a lot of money here. You just have to have your mind open and be ready to do everything possible to afford a car like this. So, you know, guys, this is my dream car, but it ain't my last car. There's more better cars that I can get. My next car, I would suggest, like, probably an Aston Martin or, what's that called? The Porsche GT3 RS. That's like my next car. I will never sell my Hellcat. Like I said, guys, this is like the last V8 engine. So I will never sell it. After I pay it off, I'm just going to keep it in the family. This car, you know, this is my dream car, guys. So yeah, thanks for watching. Your boy Epic Rapper signing out. Peace.